Praise the Lord, precious saints. Well, this very night, the Lord has led me to do a specific prayer and a small teaching based upon praying the will of God. Hallelujah. So the Bible tells us, according to Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 to 12, it says, "In this manner, therefore, pray, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors." Hallelujah. So if we look at in this third petition of our Father's prayer, Jesus instructs us to pray for God's will to be done. This request, it flows from the petition for God's kingdom to come, for the Lord's kingdom is present where we find righteousness, hallelujah, where we find peace, where we find joy and the Holy Spirit, according to Romans 14 verse 7. So such fruit are possible only as we do the will of God, hallelujah. So yet it might seem strange to pray for God's will to be done, but scripture is quite clear that God's will, at the least in some sense, is always done. And according to Ephesians 1 verse 1, for instance, explains that the Lord works all things according to the counsel of his will. And then we see also in Psalm 115 verse 3 adds that our God is in the heavens and he does all that he pleases. So such passages refer to what is commonly called the decretive will of God, in keeping with Deuteronomy 29 verse 29, which tells us that there are some things that the Lord has revealed and some things he has not. So, you know, even theologians have also questioned this and also spoken and distinguished between the decretive and the preceptive wills of God. The decretive will refers to God's sovereign decree of whatever comes to pass. For the most part, this will is hidden from us, but it includes everything that actually happens in creation. So if God ordains something in his decretive will, it will certainly come to pass. So our Creator's preceptive will, on the other hand, refers to those things that he finds morally pleasing in themselves. So think of the Ten Commandments, for instance, the positive things they enjoin, such as the preservation of life, chastity, contentment, and so forth, are all pleasing to God. So it is his will that will is to bring the things to pass that he approves of. However, we know that God's preceptive will is routinely broken. So people violate the commandments, so they go against the preceptive will. Yet in such cases, we note that they are not going against his decretive will. For the sake of some greater good, God decrees that some things that are in themselves detestable, sin, and that violate his preceptive will. Christ's crucifixion is a great example of this. God ordained that those who murdered his son would do their evil deeds. So considered in itself, he hates that act of injustice, according to Acts 2 verse 23. Those men who had Christ killed violated God's preceptive will against murder. Even so, God decreed the crucifixion for a greater final good, and namely our salvation and his glory, according to Romans 8 verse 28. So to pray for God's will to be done is to pray for the preceptive will to be kept. So yet it is more than that. It is to ask that people would do his this will, not merely out of duty, but because they want to serve God with all of their heart. So it is not wrong to do God's will because it is our duty to obey Him. However, God wants us to be content with His will, to seek to do His will, not merely out of duty, but because we are delighted to follow His commandments by His grace. Over the course of our lives, it makes us interestingly willing to obey Him even when it's hard. So we can understand that, you know, Romans 8 verses 25 and 26, it says, "Likewise, the Spirit also helps us in our weaknesses, for we do not know what we should pray as we ought, but the Spirit Himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered." And in verse 27, it says, "Now he who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because he makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God." So for us, for the Holy Spirit to come and help us, bring us into the Father's will, we must learn to surrender our will. So is your will stronger than God's will? Now, God's will for our lives has reason and purpose. It is through Scripture that we can find meaning and principles discerning God's wills. So when we look at the following verses, we see in Jeremiah 29 verse 11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you, plans not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future." In 1 Timothy chapter 2 verses 3 to 4, it says, "This is good and pleases God our Savior, who wants all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth." Or 2 Thessalonians 5:18, "Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus." Or 1 Thessalonians 4:3, "It is God's will that you should be sanctified, that you should avoid sexual immorality." So God's will is for us to be cleansed from such terrible things that would come against us. We can also see, according to Luke 9 verses 23, "Then he said to them all, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me." So here we see denying oneself is to deny one's will. And when we deny our will, then the Holy Spirit, who intercedes on our behalf, will direct us into the Father's will. Hallelujah. So this is God's word for us. Hallelujah. God wants us to bring us into His will. 1 Peter 2:15 says, "For it is God's will that by doing good, you should silence the ignorant talk of foolish people." So when you do God's will and goodwill towards God, He will even silence the foolish people that must be against us. Hallelujah. Now, in Ephesians 5, verse 15, it says, "Be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise." Verse 16, "Making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil." Then verse 17, "Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is." Hallelujah. And then it goes on to say, "Do not be drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit, speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and with spiritual songs," and so forth. Hallelujah. So if we want to be in the Lord's will, then it requires us to submit our will, that the Holy Spirit's will can be done in our life. Hallelujah. So the Bible says in Micah 6 verse 8, "He has shown you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with our God." Hallelujah. This is God's will for your life. Hallelujah. Hebrews 10:36, "You need to persevere so that when you have done the will of God, you will receive what He has promised." Hallelujah. So God, your word says to us that whatever we bind on earth is bound in heaven, and whatever we loosen on earth is loosened in heaven. Therefore, on the authority of your word, we decree and we declare and we bind every force that has set itself against us in any way possible, whether it be bringing us into your perfect will, whether it be against our finances, whether it be to bring whatever it is, we hereby declare all curses against us null, void, and harmless. And we are redeemed from the curses of poverty, from the curses of sin, and we are free from all oppression today in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare and decree that this is a year in which God has heard our cries for mercy, and the things are going to start to turn around according to Psalm 116 verses 1. I love the Lord, for he heard my voice. He heard my cry for mercy because he turned his ear to me, and I will call on him as long as I live. And Lord, we pray right now that we speak the opening of heavenly gates and ancient doors that will bring us into deep relationship with you, God, according to Psalm 24, verse 7. Lift up your heads, you gates. Be lifted up, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. And we also decree a time of renewing our strength and soaring in the presence of God, according to Isaiah 40, verse 31. But those who wait and those that hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not go weary, and they will walk and not faint. And we declare that the times of spiritual hopelessness and disappointment have come to an end, and this is the year of sudden good breaks in the name of Jesus Christ. And we pray according to Proverbs 13, verse 12, unrelenting disappointment leaves you heartsick, but a sudden good break can turn life around. Hallelujah. We just thank you, Lord Jesus. Make us, Lord, ministers of reconciliation to offset injustice and bring healing to people everywhere we go in your perfect will. According to 2 Corinthians 5, verse 18, it says, all this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. Hallelujah. We, Heavenly Father, we pray right now also. We agree with the new things that will bring spiritual refreshment to those who have been in the wilderness. Lord, we pray for all them to be brought into the perfect will of God, according to Isaiah 43, verse 18 and 19. Forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. And we just pray also right now, Father, we declare a new day as God's light shines on and through us, according to Isaiah 60, verse 1. Arise and shine, for your light is come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord Jesus. And Father, you help us to be stretched in order to receive all that you have for us. Lord, according to your word, it says in Isaiah 54, verse 2, it says, enlarge the place of your tent. Stretch your tent curtains wide. Do not hold back. Lengthen your cords and strengthen your stakes. Hallelujah. The vision you have for us is bigger than we can imagine. Lord, we pray right now, Father, that you would teach us to love as you love us, God. We ask this, Father, according to your word. It says in Matthew 22, verse 37 onwards, it said, Jesus replied, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your mind and soul. Hallelujah. And this is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is to love your neighbor as yourself. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We praise you, Father. Lord, that you would give us wisdom to help those who need the love of God. According to Luke 1, verse 17, and he will go on before the Lord in the spirit and the power of Elijah to turn the hearts of the parents to the children, and from the disobedient obedient to the wisdom of the righteousness, to make ready the people and to prepare them for the day of the Lord. Hallelujah. And we also ask, Father, that you would grant us the ability to forgive and not judge others. According to Luke 6, verse 37, do not judge and you will not be judged. Do not condemn and you will not be condemned. Forgive and you'll be forgiven. Give and it will be given to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together and running over. And it will be poured out into your lap, for with the measure you use is the measure will be given to you. And we thank you, Father. We gladly receive any pruning needed in our lives in order for us to remain in you and within your perfect will, Lord. And we thank you for that. In John 15, verses 5 to 6, it says, I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. But if you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up and thrown and into the fire and burn. But Lord, we thank you, Lord Jesus. And we ask you, Father, we decree right now that we will step into a place this remaining of this year to have great authority to see answers to things we ask for in this prayer right now. According to John 15, verse 7, if you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish and it shall be done for you. Father, we thank you that we are in agreement, Lord, with your promises to pour out your Spirit on our descendants and declare that we will see them grow fast and strong. According to Isaiah 44, verse 3 onwards, for I will pour water onto the thirsty and streams on the dry ground, and I will pour out my Spirit on your offspring and my blessing on your descendants. So we also ask, Father, we open up opportunities to us to see who needs that deeper touch. Lord, use us to bring healing to the people who have been wounded and rejected. According to Luke 14, verse 21, go out quickly into the streets and into the alleys of the town and bring in the poor, the crippled, the blind and the lame. And we ask, Father, and we pray for the new sound from heaven to be released upon the earth, according to Revelation 14, verse 2. And I heard a sound from heaven like the roar of a rushing waters, like a loud peal of thunder. The sound I heard was like that of harpers playing their harps. And we declare also right now and decree, we declare and decree that we will live our lives the remaining of this year and the years to come above all the negativity around us. We look for doors of opportunity and ask for eyes to see all that you are doing, Lord, and all where you are leading us, according to Revelation 4, verse 1. After this I looked, and there before me was a door standing open in heaven. And the voice I first heard speaking to me like a trumpet said, come up here and I will show you what must take place after this. Lord, we thank you right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We now loose the abundance of God and of all rightfully belongs to us now to come upon us. Lord, as we come under the grace in a perfect way in the name of Jesus, and we make these declarations from today. Heavenly Father, we come to you in prayer to magnify, to glorify your holy name, and we give you all the praise and the glory you deserve. Omnipotent King, thank you for today. Thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for health and strength and wisdom and prosperity and favor is not only in our life, but also in within our family's life. And according to Romans 12, verse 2, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that tests that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. Lord, what is your will for us? Lord, what is your will for us? Lord, we are completely and totally open to your plan for our lives. Guide us, Lord, according. Take control of our lives and lead us into plain paths of righteousness. Lord, execute your will within our lives. Reveal to us your purpose. Draw near as we cry out, O merciful Savior. Lord, we hunger and thirst after your holy presence. Change us, Lord. Infiltrate into the depths of our heart. Mend our broken spirit so that that we will be transformed and become brand new. We thank you, Lord Jesus, according to 1 Thessalonians 4:3, for this is the will of God for sanctification, that abstain from sexual immorality. Lord, what is your will for us? Lord, we are completely and totally open to this will. We embrace this transformation right now. As we embrace this new transformation, Lord, continue to unfold your plans for our life daily. And step by step, as you hold our hands and take the lead, and we will eventually become what you have desired us to be. All the glory and worship will be submitted unto you for the great works that you have done in us. Oh, Lord, continue to unfold your plans in our daily life. According to Colossians 1 verses 9 onwards, for this reason, since the day we heard about you, you have not stopped praying for you and asking God to fill you with the knowledge of his will through all spiritual wisdom and understanding. And we pray this in order, Lord, that you may live a life worthy of the Lord, and we may please him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened with all power according to his glorious might, so that you may have great endurance and patience and joyful giving to the Father, who has qualified you to share in the inheritance of the saints in the kingdom of light. Hallelujah. God, you know us better than we know ourselves. You know our fears. You know our desires. You know how much we want this. You know how much and how devastated we are without you, Lord Jesus. We know, and we know you love us. We know that you have a plan for us. Please, Lord, don't let our desires blind us to your will. If this is not your will or your plan for us, then throw it up against the brick wall. Give us, Lord, we pray, give us an obstacle that we cannot get past that thing if it's not your will. Help us follow your will, Father. Give us peace about whatever is to come. If this falls through, we know that it is in your hands. Father, we sing praise unto your precious and mighty name. We give you and thank you for all that you have done. Be with us daily, Lord. Guide us and protect us from every and remove every obstacle in our way. Lord, lead us along the plain paths of righteousness. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your will to be done. Be with us, Lord, and remove us and lead us to success. Oh, Heavenly Father, bless us with divine favor and mercy and all powers preventing us from attaining our breakthrough. Remove it today. Anything from our career, wedding, marriage, let there be light in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, we thank you. Whatever is blocking us from you, Father, remove it. Whatever we are doing, Lord, that is distracting us from you, Father, we repent of it. Whatever we need to do that we haven't done before to bring us closer to you, Father, reveal it, because we want to know that we know you purely and intimately, that we know you thoroughly and completely, that we know you heartfully and purposefully, that we know you, Lord God. Today, let nothing get in our way, Father, as we make our list in our heads of all the things, Lord, that we need to bring brought into right standing with you. Whatever those deepest desires of our hearts that are unfulfilled, remind us that they aren't silly or unattainable dreams, but anything's impossible with you. Lord, we thank you, oh God, that we ask you to help us. We can't do this on our own. Fill in the gaps, God, because according to your word, it said in Isaiah 54 verse 14, your word says, build up, prepare the road, remove the obstacles out of the way of my people. Father, today we ask that you remove the obstacles in our path to living a fulfilling life. Remove anything that distracts us from you. Remove any piece of doubt and fear. Remove any feelings of apathy. Help us to wake up and walk with you. Let nothing stand in our way in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, we pray right now. Lord, we thank you right now that we will lift up our our eyes to the hills. From whence comes our help? Our help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He will keep you from slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall either sleep nor slumber. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and coming in from this time forth and forevermore. Father, we come to you today with faith, and we know, Lord, whatever it is, whatever that faith, even though our faith is small and we cannot see a way, we want to believe that you are able to do more than we can imagine. We want to walk by faith and not by sight. God, please bring a miracle into our lives. We know that you can do the impossible in our lives, and we are trusting for your promises. Thank you for being a God who sees and hears every need that we have. Heavenly Father, thank you for answering our prayers and performing miracles in our life every day. Just the fact that we woke up this morning, can take a breath, is a gift from you. Help us to never take our health or loved ones for granted. Help us to always stand in faith and keep our focus on you with any unexpected circumstances. Oh Lord, dear God, we thank you that you love us and that you want us to keep us from depending on other things instead of you. Forgive us for when we have depended on our job or other people instead of you. Thank you that you haven't forgotten us. Lord, the days ahead may be a little scary at times, but we understand now that the path to a miracle is through uncomfortable territory. And we understand now that the source of our miracle will be unexpected. So we shouldn't try to figure anything else. But we ask you help us to submit our ways that the Holy Spirit may bring us into the perfect will of God. We thank you, Lord, for every promise of God that is yes and amen. We claim it today and believe you for greater things. Lord, I pray for your anointing to touch each and every person right now that needs a special touch from you. Touch them from the top of the head to the soles of your feet right now. Touch them with your anointing and your power. In Jesus' mighty name, this is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrow Path Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom.